So here we go with your 602 late model qualifying. First car out going to be the 25 of David Singleton. Singleton's first lap going to be a 16-251. 16-251. Cranfield going to try to give chase. It's going to be a 16-583. 16-583. As David Singleton going to try his best to better from lap number one. He will go a 16-273. As that will be top of the board, but Spencer Cranfield says he has something to say about it. He's going to try it one more time. 16-710. 16-710, not enough. So your next two pair of qualifiers out, it's going to be the D2 of Darren Goins. Darren Goins usually runs with our steelheads here sometimes, as well as he's got a 602 late model motor, as he's put that in for tonight, as we've got the 51 of Bradley Hamilton. B-Rad in the 51, going to be on the clock this time around. Goins, lap number one for him, going to be a 16-583, 16-583. Hamilton, he will go a 16-431, 16-431. As that will put Hamilton second quick so far. As Darren Goins, lap number two, much better second quick for Darren Goins on lap number two. But Bradley Hamilton says, I want the number two spot. He's going to take it away from him. So Hamilton going to move up to second. So your next two pair of cars out to qualify in that mighty fine looking number 71. That's going to be Nick Miley. And going to be giving chase to him in the Roberts Construction back. Number 8W, that's going to be Blake Wright. Nick Miley, lap number one for him. He will go a 16-389. That will be good enough for fourth quick. As Blake Wright going to cross the stripe on lap number one, he will jump up to fifth quick with a 16-395, 16-395. As Nick Miley going to try it again, he's going to come down Main Street one last time. He'll hit the clock no better than his first lap, 16-490, 16-490, lap number two for Miley. As Blake Wright, he will not improve as well, 16-582, 16-582 for Blake Wright. As they're going to make that hard left into the infield pit area, as that's where we are staging them for tonight. We'll get them off the racing surface here in just a moment. So here we go. Your next pair is going to be the 22 of Dustin Ward. Going to be giving chase to him. That is the I-75-backed number 19 CVR race car. It's going to be Michael Courtney in the Nick Perry-owned machine. Michael Courtney, multi-time feature winner here at I-75. First lap for Dustin Ward. He'll jump up to second quick. 16-309, 16-309. As Michael Courtney, he wants to take the number two a spot away. He will. 16-292, 16-292. As Dustin Ward going to try his best to better on lap number two. Not going to get it done. Michael Courtney has a shot at your fast time right here. Will he take it? No. 16-343 on lap number two. Loses about a tenth. Front wheel drives, you need to be making your way to staging. Front wheel drive, you need to be making your way to staging at this time. So here we go with the 426 of Dylan Cole, going to be giving chase to him. That is the Yamaha backed number 9 of Josh Cheatham. So lap number one for Cole, going to be a 16.366. As Josh Cheatham, going to be a 16.526. Dylan Cole going to fall off just a little bit from lap number one, but he'll keep his fast time. Josh Cheatham, 16.907 on lap number two. Your fast time still belonging to the 25 of David Singleton. So here we go with the next pair. It's going to be the 0-3 of Dante Curtis. Going to be giving chase to him, the 5. Mighty fine-looking race car. That's going to belong to Curtis Thomas. Dante, lap number 1, 16.675, 16.675. Curtis Thomas going to be toward the top of the board with a 16.392. As Dante, going to be a 16.511 on lap number 2. 16.511. As Curtis Thomas, he will be 8th quick on the field so far in that good-looking 5 machine. Once again, front-wheel drive. You need to be in staging. Front-wheel drives. You need to be in staging at this time. As here we go with your next pair coming out on the racing surface. That will be the 7 of Brandon Ward. And going to be giving chase to him. That is the new Cardwell on the block. That's going to be Davin Cardwell in your 602 late model division. Brandon Ward, lap number 1 for him, going to be a 16703, 16703. Cardwell going to bring that race car out of turn number 4, 16341. That'll be good enough for 6th quick. As Davin Cardwell is not going to settle for 6th. He's going to try his best to make his way up through the ranks. Ward going to go 16.368, 16.368, better than last lap. As Davin going to be a 16.314. That'll be good enough for 4th quick. As they run right now, he will start on the outside of row number 2 in your 602 late models. Front wheel drives, you need to be in staging. So here we go. It's going to be the 20 of Tyler Nichols. Going to be on the clock this time around. And then it's going to be the 101 service, or service 101 backed machine of Reed Hackett. The lap number 1 for Nichols is going to be a 16.623. As Reed Hackett now, 16.467, 16.467. Hackett had a couple of starts here at I-75 in the 2022 season. Glad to see him back. Nichols going to go 16.445, 16.445. As the 101 of Hackett made a little bit of a mistake over in turn 3 and 4. That'll hurt his second lap. But he will keep his fast time, which was his first lap. As that'll do it for our 602 late models. David Singleton still at the top of the board as we get ready for your final two. So Dustin Bunch now going to be on the clock this time around. Then it's going to be the only female in the group, Tiffany Hensley. Where are my females at? Make her some noise as she is now on the clock. Dustin Bunch going to go with 16.522, 16.522. Hensley going to bend that race car out of turn number 4. She will go a 17.624, 17.624. Dustin Bunch going to make his way out of turn 3 and 4. Once again, it'll be a 16.538, 16.538. Tiffany Hensley looks like she might have a little bit of a pushing issue through turn three and four, but she'll bring it across the line for the last time. 17-2-9-3, as that will officially do it for our 602 late models. David Singleton going to start on your maid of honor spot right here in our 602 late models. Front wheel drive, you need to be in staging. Front wheel drive, you need to be in staging. You race fans alive out there? I haven't seen you guys do much moving around. You guys still with me? I see one person with their thumb up. Two people. Okay. At least I know three people are still with me. We'll work on the rest. What happened to my friend over here in the orange cutoff? Is she still here? Oh, she's over there. Okay. Just making sure you're still here and not leaving us. Here we go, heat race number one for your front wheel drive. It's going to be six laps in distance. This will determine where they start in tonight's feature event. Travis Weeks and the 25 of John Walker are going to be on your front row. Six laps is going to be the distance. They will see the green flag out of turn number four. As you'll see them two by two, nose to tail. Down the back straightaway, they're not allowed to fire unless they're in between that KRC starting restart zone. As we go underway, front wheel drive style heat race one. So as Roderick and the 21 Brad Center gets a little bit out of shape. Or Travis Taylor, I apologize. Get a little bit out of shape, but give it to the 85 of Travis Weeks on lap number one. Ryan Harness going to be second. John Elliott, John Walker, Travis Taylor, Zach Roderick, Raymond Fusion, and the two of Austin Croft going to round out the field as now Harness going to try to track down your race leader. Harness now going to take a peek underneath the skirt of Weeks. It's going to be a drag race into turn number three. Does Harness have enough off the bottom of turn number four to take over the race lead? Yes. Give it to the 13 of Ryan Harness on lap number three. As now Harness going to try to stretch out that race lead from the 85 of Weeks, but the race is going to be back here for your fourth position between the 13 of Roderick, Elliott, and Fusion. White flag going to be displayed for the 13 of Harness. Heat race number two for your front wheel drive. You need to be in staging. Heat race number two is Ryan Harness entering turn number three out of four. He'll pick up tonight's heat race number one win in your front wheel drive division, followed by the 85 of Weeks. And then the 21 of Travis Taylor going to round out your top three. All right. So here we go, heat race number two. We go underway. So Jack Grisham going to pick up heat race number two as he is looking to start outside pole for tonight's feature event. Here we go, heat race number three. Dustin Duncan going to lead us off a turn at number four. We go underway. Thank you. So the checker gonna fall on the 21 of Dustin Duncan. He will start third on the field tonight. Larry McCurry gonna be second. And Brad Webb gonna round out your top three. So Michael Lehman going to be fastest so far as the 27 of Cameron Hawkins going to be a 16.385. So here we go, Jeremy Webb going to be in the 95. He's going to be on the clock this time by. Then, going to be giving chase to him. It's going to be the 96 of Ed Morphew. So Michael Lehman gonna be your fast qualifier so far, as here we go with your next two. William Blankenship, you and your race car are needed at staging. William Blankenship, you and your race car are needed at staging. As the next pair of qualifiers out, gonna be the 47 of Johnny Vanover. Gonna be giving chase to him. It's gonna be the 9 of Justin Howard. And this is your B Sportsman Division. Thunder Cars, you need to be in staging. Thunder Cars, you need to be in staging. So Vanover going to go 17-801, 17-801, and followed by him the 9 of Justin Howard with a 16-869. Your fast time so far, 16-365. Is the 144 of Jonathan Campbell going to loop it around over in turn number 4? That'll bring out the caution as he was coming to the checkered. So attention to the grandstands. We need everybody to please back off the fence. Please, if everybody could please back off of the fence, as we don't need anything like that to happen. Worst case scenario. So the 144 of Campbell going to make the hard left into the infield pit area. So here we go, next two qualifiers out. That's going to be the 91 of John Judd, going to be giving chase to him. First time here to I-75, that'll be the 72 of Billy Woods. As he is now on the clock, Judd going to bring it out of turn number four. He'll hit the clock on lap number one. He'll go a 17.040. As Billy Woods going to strike the clock at a 17.167. 17.167. Second and final lap for John Judd. Going to be a 17.789. 17.789. As he made a little bit of a mistake over in turn number one and two. Hurt his lap time. And Billy Woods going to be awfully close to his first lap time. 17.105. Here we go with your final qualifier in your B Sportsman division. That's going to be the 78 of Chris Webb. Here's Chris Webb going to be an 18.424. So Chris Webb going to go 19.051 on lot number two, as that'll do it for URB Sportsman qualifying. Will Hicks going to go fast time with a 16.187, as we're going to get these guys off the racing surface and get ready for opening ceremonies. Don't forget about our young ladies selling 50-50 tickets in the grandstands, as someone's going to walk out of here with some cold hard cash.
On behalf of the American All-Star Series, presented by PPM Racing Products, we're going to make you the official flagman for the series here tonight. And also, when we get ready to go for the Stars in the Valley, we don't want you flagging down here. We're going to put you up there in the flag stand to wave the green flag with our flagman as well. Let's hear it for this young man. This is what I love about this sport. Raise them in racing, they won't want to do anything else but be part of it. It takes away anything, pretty much. Kids get out there, they get rowdy, they want to do drugs, they want to do this, that, and the other. They come to the racetrack, I promise you, none of that will enter their mind. That's the only thing they'll worry about is the smell of race fuel over there. Y'all guys, let's get ready once again. Let's hear it for our junior flagman here tonight at I-75.
We're going green next time by Don McCourt, 74 Robert Russell, your pole row. Green flag is out. They're door-to-door going into one. Robert Russell on the outside. They're still door-to-door. down the backstretch. Roger Smith to the inside of Bunkin Wyrick. Roger Smith up to second. He's knocking on the door for that pole position. Don McCourt right there. He's looking to the low side. Don McCourt's on the outside. Bunkin Wyrick looking to the outside. Three wide coming out of four. Don McCourt added that lap. Roger Smith door to door with Don McCourt. Down the backstretch they go. Don McCourt has it. Down the backstretch. Roger Smith still holding that inside. Roger Smith saves it. The caution, nope. The caution flag is out. Don McCourt leads the field to the green flag. Bunkin Wyrick looks to the inside. Roger Smith making no time to get back in that top three. He's on the inside of Robert Russell. Bunkin Wyrick looking to the inside of Don McCourt. Don McCourt has it this lap, but not by much. They're door-to-door going into one. They're door-to-door down the backstretch. Don McCourt pulling away just a little bit. Bunkin still to the inside. Don McCourt pushes up a little bit. Bunkin Wyrick gets it that time. Roger Smith still. Roger Smith makes his way up to third. Don McCourt still chasing down Bunkin Wyrick. Robert Russell. The white flag is out, Bunkin out front. And Bunkin Wyrick wins. Don McCourt behind him. Roger Smith, Robert Russell, and Brian Keith.
B-Hobby, you should be in staging. B-Hobby, you need to be in staging. So here we go. Brady Lee gonna get the line, put it on his turn number four. Ryan Watson gonna make it a drag race off into turn number one. Brady Lee's got the preferred line there, right through the middle. Ryan Watson gonna try the high side. And if any of you guys watched at home from the Tuesday race, from Ray Cook's race, the high side is awfully treacherous off turn two. So as we're going to pull them back, we're going to pull them back one more time and shoot them off down the front straightaway. Good even start. As once again, Brady Lee's got the better preferred line out of turn number two. Ryan Watson all over the backside of him. He's going to take a look underneath the skirt of him. Didn't like what he saw. Had to back off just a little bit, but give lap number one to the 31 of Brady Lee. Brady Lee putting on an absolute spectacle. Lap number one for him. He was 2 tenths faster than the 11 of Ryan Watson. There's the 39 of Bryson Hogan. Loops it around over in turn number four. Is that'll bring out the caution flag. Also, as we get ready to go green, don't forget about our 50-50 tickets walking up to the grandstands at this time. Get yourself $1 for a ticket or six for five. Mr. Dennis up here has got a handful of them. If you win, I get half, right?
We
got to
split up Shannon.
We got to split up Shannon three ways. I'll take 33%. As we go back underway in your B-Hobby, Brady Lee's still going to be finding the lap pedal. As he goes down the back straightaway, he's got about a 2/10 lead over your number two man of Ryan Watson. So is the caution going to come out once again on the B39? So we go four laps into this 15-lap feature event. Brady Lee once again all over the skinny pedal. So Brady Lee still showing the way, 1.0 seconds ahead of your second place man, Ryan Watson. And then you're going to take a few seconds back. Then it's going to be the 51 of Dalton King and Matt Crabtree. So checkered flag and a wave on the 31 of Brady Lee. As he will come down the back straightaway. And once again in front of the grandstands, ladies and gentlemen, give it up for the 31 of Brady Lee taking home your B-Hobby feature event. So here we go, guys, with your 602 late models. Front wheel drive, we need you in staging. Front wheel drive, need you in staging. Michael Courtney and David Singleton going to be on the front row of this 20-lap feature event. So we're going to ease off into turn number four. Here we go, 602 late model style. Good start for the 25 of David Singleton. Nick Perry, number 19, piloted by Michael Courtney. Going to get a good run off and down the back straightaway. So David Singleton going to be on the bottom side of turn one and two. Michael Courtney still going to rim right around the top side. As you're looking for the 22 of Dustin Ward, going to be third, fourth, going to be Davin Cardwell. And Darren Goins going to finish at your top five as Cardwell and Goins going to go door to door. So this race scheduled for 20 laps. As we got one looped around over on turn number three and four, that's going to be the 7 of Tiffany Hensley. So Michael Courtney going to be on the front row of this Delaware Double File restart. David Singleton and the 22 of Dustin Ward going to be on your first full row. Cardwell and Miley going to be on the second full row as we're going to go back underway. So the caution will come out on the 3. That's going to belong to Dante Curtis, as he will be charged the caution. He will go to the tail end of the field. So here we go, Michael Courtney going to ease off into 3 out of 4. Going to go back underway with your 602 late models. David Singleton going to be second. And it's going to be Dustin Ward, Nick Miley, and then your top 5 going to be rounded out by Brandon Ward in the 7. As we've got them bunched up like the rush hour traffic through Knoxville back there toward the rear. As it looks like the 2 of Goins going to be coming to a slow on the back straightaway. So we got him lined back up. Michael Courtney got on the front row once again. As we're going to ease off into turn number 3 out of 4. Here we go. So we get once again Michael Courtney going to lead us on turn number four. Front wheel drive. You need to be in staging. Front wheel drive. You need to be in staging. So David Singleton going to fall back to third as he's got some company from the 71 of David Miley. Davin Cardwell looking to get a top five. And your 602 late model is just a mere 15 years old as he is in that red and white number 70. The 9 of Dustin Bunch going to throw it off in there harder than a kid on prom night. As he made it stick through 1 and 2. It looks like he's going to come out on the winning deal of that one. He's going to take 6th spot away from Brandon Ward. So Michael Courtney going to take home your 602 late model feature event, followed by the 22 of Brandon Ward. And then the 25 of Dust, David Miley. As that will conclude your 602 late models front wheel drive, you're needed on the racing surface. So here we go, front wheel drives out of turn number four. Harness and Grisham going to lead us off of turn number four. Then you got the 21 of Duncan and Weeks going to be on your second full row. So the white flag going to be displayed that time around. Your race leader, the 13 of Ryan Harness, looking to pick up the four-wheel drive feature event. As he brings it out of turn number four, give it up for the 13 of Ryan Harness. Followed by Travis Weeks and Dustin Duncan, your top three. So here we go, the Sportsman Division. Will Hicks gonna lead us off turn four. We go underway. So is the 95 of Jeremy Webb looped it around over in turn number three and four. That'll bring out our caution flag. So we go full restart. No laps were scored. We're going to go underway. Will Hicks going to get the lap put on at four. Here we go. And then you got the 20 of Michael Lehman outside row number one. As Hicks got a good start, Lehman now going to fall into second. Then you got the 26 of Cameron Hawkins. Here we go, Will Hicks. Going to try it again. 78. Going to loop it around over in turn number three and four. So we're going to go single file with the restart. Will Hicks going to be out front. Then it's going to be the 20 of Michael Lehman, Cameron Hawkins, Jeremy Webb, and the 09 of Justin Howard. So once again, one more try at this single file restart. So the 144 of Jason, you gotta loop it around over in turn number three and four. Full attention to the pit area, 602 late model drivers from 6th on back. You need to go to the payout window at this time. 602 drivers from 6th on back. You need to go to the payout window at this time. So Will Hicks going to make his way down the back straightaway. He is looking to pick up tonight's B Sportsman feature event through 3 out of 4. Will Hicks picking up B Sportsman, followed by the 27 of Cameron Hawkins and the 20 of Michael Lehman.